This one. Sorry. Sorry, class. This is not 8. 0. 600 to 630. Okay? So, when he first play attack, the ruler was Mahendra. Which dynasty? Pallava. And this Pulakeshin second, in the first one, was successful. Not the Mahendravarman. Try to understand this thing. It is he. Because we are all discussing with reference to whom?
Pulakeshin.
With reference to Pulakeshin too. So, inke liye likh rahe hain, successful. In the second attack, first of all, second, unsuccessful. Unsuccessful. And this time the ruler was? Narasimha. First. Narasimhavarman first, clear? The next ruler of this dynasty was Vijayaditya. I am writing his name on the top of the board so that everyone can see. Vijayaditya. Vijayaditya. Period 696 to 733. Period is 696 to 733. Clear? And you write here only one thing which is important. The great Shiva temple. At Pattadakkal. P-A-double-T-A. D-A-K-A-L, P-A-T-T-A-D-A-K-A-L, Pattadakkal, was built during his period. So now you got it? Simple, huh? Any difficulty? Okay. Now we will switch over to the Pallavas. So Pallava ruling at Kanchi or Kanchipuram, Tamil Nadu. And founder Simhavishnu, Simhavishnu, see, in Hindi we call it as Simhavishnu, but while writing in English we use the word M. So Simhavishnu, Simhavishnu. Here, period of rule 565 to 600. 565 to 600. And the only important thing about him is that class. His court poet was Bharavi. B-H-A-R-A-V-I. B-H-A-R-A-V-I. Bharavi. So he wrote a book. Aur us book ka naam. The name of that book is Kiratarjuniya. Kiratarjuniya. One more class to go. That would be the last class of last presence of Abhishek Parma. So, I am very much, what you can say, free with you. Okay? So, the people who are having good day or any other kind of biscuits, do you know anything about Kiratarjuniya? Sarmani Gyoti maang nahi rahe yaar, dekho. Man maanga hai toh apna sar mat peeto. Kahan se? MP se ho, beech wale jo aap hai? Nahin, kis jagah se? बिहार से, किरातर जूनियर, महाभारत सुने महाभारत? सो देयर इज अ स्टोरी इन महाभारत दैट अर्जुन वाज एडवाइस दैट यू शुड गेट पाशुपत वेपन, एंड पाशुपत वेपन वाज द वेपन ऑफ शिवा. सो ही स्टार्टेड मेडिटेटिंग फॉर गेटिंग दैट पाशुपत वेपन. मीनवाइल व्हाट हैपेंड, द प्लेस वेयर ही वाज मेडिटेटिंग, a wild boar came nearby him and he started getting disturbed. Simultaneously, Lord Shiva changed his form and appeared on the earth as a tribe, as a tribal people, as a tribal person. And the tribal, at that time a tribe was called as, Kirata, K-I-R-A-T-A, it's called as Kirat. So he changed the form and appeared as a Kirat. And he threw his weapon on the boar. Where on the other side, Arjun is also getting disturbed. So he also took his Gandiv, that dhanus, bow, and shot at boar. And both the weapon struck together and killed the boar. So these two people started fighting. It is me who had killed the animal first, Shiva is saying. It is me who had killed the first, but Arjun was not recognizing him as Shiva. So then he showed him, the real Shiva. So Arjun felt sort of, you can say, guilty or something like that. So that is the play called as Kirata Arjuniya, combining these two names. Okay, Kirat plus Arjun is Arjuniya, Kirata Arjuniya. Okay. Next is Sima Vishnu successor. Now, board pe dekho class aap log. Ek second. Sima Vishnu, when is dying?
600.
When is dying? 600. And 600 is also the beginning of another ruler's period. Mahendravarman. One. So it means he is the son and the successor of Sima Vishnu. Very simple. So Sima Vishnu was succeeded by Mahendravarman first. Okay? Am I right? And Mahendravarman first was a great, you can say, a writer and a musician also. Mahendravarman first was a great writer and a musician also. Are you getting point? Okay? So he wrote a book. He wrote a book called as, write it down, Matta Vilas Prahasan. M-A-T-T-A-V-I-L-A-S. M-A-T-T-A-V-I-L-A-S-A, Matta Vilas hyphen Prahasan, P-R-A-H-S-A-N, Matta Vilas Prahasan. Fine? P-R-A-H-S-A-N, Prahasan, comma, a satire on Kapali. Satire, do you know?
Yes.
Okay, sarcastic tone mein jo kitab likhi jati hai. Satire on Kapali. Kapali, you already know? Okay, the sect which eat and drink in human skull. So it's a sarcastic remark on the Kapali. In his early life, he was a follower of Jainism. But later, under the influence of, Saiv Saint, S-H-A-I-V-A, Saiv Saint, S-A-I-N-T, Saint, Appar, Shiv Shant Nam, okay, Shiv Ko Upasak, Lord Shiva's devotee, a very great saint or saintly figure in the South Indian history, called as Appar, Naam Unka, A-P-P-A-R, Appar. UP Bihar Kapar nahi hai, it's Appar, A-P-P-A-R, Appar. So under the influence of Saiv Saint, Appar got converted to Shaivism. Another symbol. It was he who had been attacked by whom? Pulkesin II. Pulkesin II was successful. He got defeated. So he felt very much ashamed, embarrassed that he had been defeated by his rival. So he committed suicide, class. This person had committed suicide because he could not face this kind of embarrassment that he had lost the battle. Good problem, class? As his father had committed suicide, so the son will try to take revenge. Bollywood movie banalo. Father had been killed by the enemy. So when the son will be young, he will try to take the revenge of his father. So when second time, means Mahendravarman first was succeeded by his son, who is he? Narasimhavarman first. Narasimhavarman first is the successor of Mahendravarman first. You can check the years also. Same is true, son. Mahendravarman, 565 to 600, 600 to 630, 630 to 668. Fine. So when Pulakesin second, this time, second time when he launched the attack on Pallavas, Pallava ruler Narasimhavarman first defeated whom? Pulakesin second and took the revenge of, okay, that earlier defeat of his father. And as he conquered Pallava kingdom, okay, he conquered his capital. Where is the capital? Badami or Watapi. So he took the title. Who? This man, this ruler, is taking the title, and the title was, class, Watapi Konda. Pareshan mat ho, hum hai, theek hai, hum aapko simplify karke denge. Watapi Konda. Watapi, you know, and Konda means, or Kond means conqueror. Okay, Kond is conqueror. So one who conquered Watapi is Watapi Konda. So decisions should not be, decisions are always contextual. Yeah. When you look at some of the decisions taken in your life, okay, from future, you will think that you should not have done this. So I feel when I teach history, I feel I should have joined the coaching for general studies. Because this particular chapter, Pallava or Chalukya and all, if you start studying back your home, half of you would have surrendered. नहीं होता भाई, ठीक है? Is it okay? So मैंने बहुत time waste कर दिया. मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इनको prepare करने में GS के इतने सारे मुझे coaching करनी चाहिए थी अपने time पे, preparation के time पे. I should have joined the institute because I feel like it's more simple. Okay. At least you get to know that what is important, what is not important, the proper strategy, how to read and all. Okay. So this is the ruler called Narasimhavarman first. ठीक है? Now he took the title Watapi Konda, and he had another title. Tamil students will tell me. Anyone from Tamil Nadu? Disappear ho jayega bachcha. So he took a title. Ma'am from Kerala? No. You might be knowing its title. Mambal. Yeah, wrestler. You knew it, okay? And I had faith in you that, okay, but you did not utter this word. Mambal means wrestler. Okay. दिल्ली, आपसे मैम नाम भूल गया, जो भी है, ठीक है? तो महाभारत सीरियल देखी है आप? महाभारत सीरियल देखा है? इसे आपकी जो भी एज रही होगी तब आता नहीं रहा होगा टीवी पे, ठीक है? ये हमारे टाइम का सीरियल था और हम बहुत छोटे थे, बट आई वॉज वेरी हैप्पी. एंड महाभारत एंड रामायण आर टू सीरियल्स व्हिच लेड टू द सेल ऑफ द टीवी सेट्स. ओके, इट हैज इंक्रीज्ड बिकॉज़ दिस टू सीरियल्स आर टू गुड. So, in those times, in ancient times, wrestling in Hindi is also called as Mallayudh bolte hain na, Mallayudh. So, Mallayudh is what? Or Mallayudh is called as wrestling. So, from there, this word Mahamal, Maha is great, Mal is, okay. So, Mahamal or Mahamal. Mahamal is the abbreviated thing of Mahamal. Problem hoga to bata dena class. Pakka? So he is a great wrestler. He was a great wrestler. So he took the title of what? Mahamal, and also built a city on the shore on the coast of Tamil Nadu that is called as Mahabalipuram or simply Mammalpuram. Mahabalipuram or Mammalpuram. I've almost gone mad. Nothing, I can't remember. I'm losing my temper at times because in a very few days I have to complete so many classes of ancient India. तो दिन भर में मामल कहीं चल रहा है, कहीं पल्लव चल रहा है, कहीं चालुक्य, कहीं हर्षवर्धन, कहीं कालिदास, दिमाग एकदम थक गया है. So Mammalpuram is it clear? और Mahabalipuram, that is the city which he found. Class, Hindi word Pur means town. Sanskrit में इसको बोलते हैं पुरम. पुरम इज ऑलरेडी अ टाउन विच नाउ Mahabalipuram. अभी बाहुबली और उसमें महाबली था, सेम तो सुना. सो Mahabalipuram. Is it okay? And at this Mahabalipuram place, Tamil Nadu, he built the famous five Ratha temples. He built the famous five Ratha temples. If you have completed the page, next page में चले जाओ. उसी में करो, बाद में अपने को नहीं समझ में आएगा. लिख क्या रहे हो? वीडियो लिखो और अगले पेज में जाओ, ठीक है? So he built the famous five Ratha temples. Okay, at Mahabalipuram, and these Ratha temples are dedicated to the Pandava brothers. Dedicated to whom? Pandava brothers. Fine. And Ratha temples, because they were shaped in the shape of a chariot. They were in the shape of a chariot, and the biggest is of Dharmaraj. Yudhishthir. Okay. Being the eldest brother, so his temple, Ratha temple, is the biggest in size. And all these Ratha temples, five in number, dedicated to Pandavas, are monolithic rock cut structure. Monolithic rock cut structure. And that's all. Move to the next. And next ruler will not be the direct successor. Narasimha. Second. Narasimha second. And his period is 680. Narasimha second is 680. Then 680 to 722, and he is Narasimha second. Had a title called as Rajasimha. 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 Okay. And two famous temples built by him is Kailasana temple at Kanchipuram. Kailasana temple at Kanchipuram. Kailasana temple at Kanchipuram. And Shore temple, Shore, Shore temple at Mahabalipuram. Shore, Shore temple at Mahabalipuram. Okay, so now coming to the Rajputas. Can you see? Visible है? Rajput? आ गई है. मैं चाहता नहीं था. याद है बचपन? तो तुम लोग का बचपन अगर दिल्ली में था तो अलग बात है कि छोटे शहर में लाइफ कट जाती, बच्चों को जो खुशी मिलती है मैं तो बता ही नहीं आ सकते. पढ़ना नहीं पड़ेगा. तो जैसे खुशी सेलिब्रेट करो, कई बार तुरंत ऐसे याद आती थी लाइफ, बहुत दुख, एकदम पढ़ना पड़ेगा. हम नहीं जानते आप लोग बहुत पढ़ाकु रहे होंगे, हम नहीं थे बचपन में. सो फाउंडर दंती दुर्ग, डीए. DNTIDURGA DNTIDURGA Danti Dur. Somewhere around 750 C. Exactly, historians have not clear that it is the exact year, but it's that's why I am saying what approximately 750 C. Yeah? Bas. Next ruler, Krishna first. KRISHN A, Krishna first. Somewhere around 756. Krishna first, 756. The most important thing about Krishna first is class. He built the famous Kailas temple at Ellora. Kailas temple at Ellora. It's a rock cut temple. It's a monolithic rock cut temple. Monolithic rock cut temple. Class, in architecture, there are two types of, in fact, three types of temples. One is called as cave temples, which are built in the shape of a cave. And there is rock cut temple. And there is a structural temple. Structural temple are freestanding temples, which we find normally in the cities. Anyone who had met the temple anywhere. Rock cut temple is what? If you have to make a rock cut temple, you have to go at the site of the stone or the mountain, where it is naturally existing. And you start cutting the stone and giving it a shape of a temple, that is called a rock cut temple. If you have assembled two, means if you have been making a temple from two, three stones, then it will not be a monolithic. Monolithic means if you found that this particular stone is too big and would be able to make a proper temple, you dug out, you, okay, stone, or you can work on it, and that it created is what called a monolithic rock cut temple. So Ellora temple is Kailas temple is a monolithic rock cut temple. And in this temple, what is unique class, on the left wall of this temple, you will find, okay, Ravan, which in Hindu mythology is believed to be demon. Ravan shaking the Mount Kailas. Ravan is, okay, that sculpture or that relief feature had been carved on the left wall of the temple where Ravan is shaking the Mount Kailas. Girls of the class B1, do you know the theme, the story behind this? Ma'am, yes, explain. So Ravan was actually Kailas mountain is considered to be what? Abode of Shiva. So Ravan is trying to, okay. There is another story also associated with it, that he was flying on a Pushpak Viman, and the Pushpak Viman of Ravan could not fly above than the Mount Kailas. How can you go beyond that Mount Kailas? Aap unse upar nahi ja sakte na, it's abode of Shiva. Bhagwan ko sun jao. So when Pushpak Viman could not fly above the Mount Kailas, he became furious, Ravan, and he started shaking the Mount Kailas. So Lord Shiva, he kept the right, means his leg, and that only the toe pressed it, and his hands and all started paining. He was crushed under this. So that theme had been depicted on the left wall of the Kailasna temple or Kailas temple at Ellora, Ravan shaking the Mount Kailas. Then the next important ruler of this dynasty is Amoghvarsh. Amoghvarsh wrote a book on Kannada poetics, Kaviraj Mag. Amoghvarsh wrote a book on Kannada poetics, Kaviraj Mag. And the second thing about him is, he was a follower of Jainism. Kaviraj Marg is a book on Kannada poetics. Kannada poetics. And second thing about him is that he was a follower of Jainism. That's it, class. After going back to your PG room hostel, okay, take 15-20 minutes break, prepare a cup of coffee or tea, and then revise the class notes of today. Today only. Don't, okay, delay this thing for 2-3 days later. आज ही पढ़ना, ठीक है? एक बार दो बार आपको देखना याद जाएगा थोड़ा, कोई बहुत tough नहीं है. Now, cholas have to be taught separately, so therefore we write cholas, also known as imperial cholas. Cholas are also known as imperial cholas. So please you continue in your own words. And when you have to write, please keep it in mind, not every word has to be written out. So there is a debate regarding cholas. History is unclear about this thing, whether they were the offshoots or the same cholas who resurfaced again, the cholas of the Sangam age, or altogether any. We are not concerned about that debate. So the cholas of the 9th century were very powerful, okay, kingdom or powerful rulers. So they are also called as imperial cholas because they had ruled over a very vast area, and not only Indian mainland but also overseas. So also known as imperial cholas. And the founder of this Chol kingdom was Vijayalaya. Can you write yourself? Imperial chola founder Vijayalaya, Vijayalaya, bracket 850 to 871, capital. See the board. Thanjavur or Tanjore. Thanjavur or Tanjore. Tamil Nadu. They were earlier feudatories of the Pallavas. Earlier feudatories, F-E-U-D-A-T-O-R-I-E-S, feudatories of the Pallavas. So class, after Vijayalaya comes a ruler who is not going to be studied in the class. After him is Adityavan. And Adityavan's period is 871 to 907. But we are not focusing on Adityavan, okay, for exam it is not very much important. Then after Adityavan, Aditya I, 871 to 907, comes a ruler who is called as Parantak first. It's important. P-A-R-A-N-T-A-K-A, Parantak. Parantak first. And Parantak first period, this will be 907 to 953. He defeated the Pallavas and the Pandyas. Pallavas and Pandyas. Class, Pandyan capital had been? Madurai. Yaad hai aapko? Pandyan capital was at Madurai. So he defeated them. So he took the title Madurai Kond. Very simple. Conqueror of Madurai. So Madurai Kond. Okay, so the two most famous rulers of the Chol kingdom, the two most famous were, so the father and the son, and the father is called as Raj Raj first. The two most famous rulers of this Chol kingdom had been Raj Raj first, whose period of rule is 985 to 1014, and Rajendra first, 1014 to 1044. मैं लिखता हूँ, पर लिखने से पहले मुझे एक मिनट का टाइम चाहिए. आप तो क्लियर दिस बोर्ड. So now the father, Raj Raj. So he defeated the ruler of Sri Lanka and captured the northern Sri Lanka. He defeated the ruler of Sri Lanka and captured northern Sri Lanka, as well as destroyed its capital, Anuradhapura. Okay. Towards the end of his period, he conquered Maldives. In 1010 CE, full stop, then you are writing. In 1010 CE, he built the famous Brihadeshwar temple at Tanjavur. Then this son, his son completely conquered Sri Lanka.